So let us study the other chemical properties of the 15th group of elements. Under that, reactivity towards hydrogen. All the 15 group elements get react with hydrogen, but the tendency of reactivity decreases from top to bottom. Therefore, the nitrogen readily react with hydrogen than the phosphorus, than the arsenic, than the antimony, than the bismuth. Therefore, they form their hydrides. So, all the 15 group elements are formed the hydrides, so that the tendency of reactivity get decreases from top to bottom. As the tendency decreases, the stability and bond dissociation enthalpy decreases. Now, the stability and bond dissociation enthalpy decreases. Why it is decreases? Due to the increase in atomic size. It means the if you want to take the ammonia, bond dissociation enthalpy means it is the amount of energy required to break the bond exists between the nitrogen and hydrogen. That is called as bond dissociation enthalpy. So, the ammonia has more bond dissociation enthalpy than the phosphine, than the arsenic hydride, than the antimony hydride, than the bismuth hydride. So, the stability, ammonia is more stable than the phosphine, than the arsenic hydride, etc. As the stability and bond dissociation enthalpy decreases due to increase in atomic size, and consequently the reducing character increases and basicity is decreases. So reducing character increases. Reducing character increases and basicity decreases. Why the basicity is decreases? That is the reason due to increase in atomic size. This is about the reactivity towards the hydrogen. Then the second one is reactivity to oxygen. All these elements, that is 15 group elements, form two oxides. One is trioxide and another is pentoxide. All these elements form two oxides. One is trioxide and pentoxide. Because your 15th group elements, as you know that, they show the oxidation state +3 as well as +5. Therefore, all the 15th group elements form two type of oxides. And the some of the oxides are show the acidic character and some of the oxides show the amphoteric nature and some of the oxides are basic in nature. So the oxide in higher oxidation state is more acidic than the lower oxidation state. If you consider the nitrogen, the trioxide and nitrogen pentoxide. So the nitrogen having oxidation state plus 5, this is plus 3. Therefore, they say that the oxide of higher oxidation state is more acidic than the lower oxidation state and the acidic character decreases down the group. Now if you observe the oxides like phosphorus trioxide and phosphorus pentoxide, then arsenic oxide and arsenic pentoxide, then antimony trioxide and antimony pentoxide and the bismuth trioxide and bismuth pentoxide. See that the acidic character decreases along the group. As the acidic character is decreases, basic character is increases. And I already said the higher oxidation state of the oxide having a more acidic nature than the lower oxidation state. Therefore, if you observe the between the nitrogen pentoxide and nitrogen trioxide, nitrogen pentoxide is more acidic than the nitrogen trioxide and nitrogen pentoxide is more acidic than the nitrogen trioxide. Similarly, the other oxides, but the acidic character from top to bottom of both oxides, both trioxides and both trioxide and pentoxides is get decreases. Therefore, the nitrogen trioxide and if you take the nitrogen trioxide and phosphorus trioxide, they are acidic in nature. They are acidic in nature. However, these are amphoteric in nature. Amphoteric in nature, but this is a basic in nature. Basic in nature. So, from this one, we can readily say that either you can take the trioxide or you can take the pentoxide, the acidic character along down the group of 15 group get decreased. As the acidic character is decreases, automatically basic character is increased. You know that the term amphoteric, that is the substance is one which shows the both acidic character and basic character, such substances are called as amphoteric substances. So this is about the reactivity towards the oxygen. Then the third one is reactivity to halogen. All the 15 group elements form two type of halides. One is trihalide and another is pentahalide. All the 15 group elements form the two type of the halides. One is trihalide and pentahalide. So these elements form the series of halides like trihalide and pentahalide. Nitrogen does not form a pentahalide due to non-availability of d orbital in the valence shell. If you take the nitrogen trichloride and nitrogen pentachloride, it do not fall, but only nitrogen trichloride is fall due to the absence of d orbital in the nitrogen. However, the other halides, other 15 group element except the nitrogen form the both halides. And the pentahalides are more covalent than the trihalides. If you take the phosphorus trichloride and phosphorus pentachloride, this phosphorus pentachloride is more covalent in nature than the phosphorus trichloride. This is because higher the positive oxidation state of central atom. So the I already said the higher oxidation state of the halides are more covalent in nature than the lower, because of the more the positive oxidation state of the central atom, and will more will be the polarizing power which increases the covalent character. Only nitrogen trichloride is known to be stable. So that is, if you take the nitrogen trichloride, it is known to be the stable the halide. Then this is about the, and the tendency of reactivity also decreases with the halogen. Then the fourth one is reactivity to metals. Metals, all the 15 group elements react with the metal to form the binary compounds. All the 15 group elements readily react with the metals to form the binary compounds, such as the calcium nitride, then calcium phosphide, then sodium arsenide, then zinc stabilized antimony, and the magnesium the bismuthide. Now between the zinc and antimony, zinc is more electropositive than the antimony. Similarly, sodium is more electropositive than the arsenic. Calcium is more positive than the phosphorus, etc. So therefore, all the 15th group elements are form the metal metallic compounds. So therefore, they are get react with the metals. So these are the chemical properties of the what the 15th group elements. After that, to study the compounds of nitrogen, under the compounds of nitrogen, first to know about the dinitrogen, and symbolically represented as N2. Now, as you know that our atmospheric air containing 78% by volume of nitrogen, therefore the dinitrogen may be produced commercially by the liquefaction and fractional distillation of the air. So by the air is get liquefied, and then by fractional distillation we get the nitrogen. And liquid nitrogen having the boiling point is 77.2 Kelvin distills out first, leaving behind the liquid oxygen. Now when you observe the boiling point of the nitrogen is 77.2 Kelvin, and that of oxygen is 90 Kelvin. So first your air is get liquefied. Your air is get liquefied, the nitrogen and oxygen get liquefied, you get other gases. So you can separate the other gases and the impurities. Then this liquid is start to distill. So this has having a lower boiling point than this one, therefore it gets distills off, leaving behind the oxygen. Thus we get the pure form of the nitrogen commercially. Therefore, the nitrogen can be obtained from the air. Then how to prepare the nitrogen in the laboratory? Let us see the method of preparation of nitrogen. The first one is by treating aqueous solution of ammonia. hydrogen,
yes,
see the reaction. When you take the aqueous solution of ammonium chloride, I am heated with sodium nitrite. Sodium nitrite, then unheated, you will get the water, sodium chloride along with the liberation of
gas.
Then the second method is by thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate. Water along with liberation of nitrogen gas along with the liberation of the nitrogen gas. Then one more method for the preparation of the nitrogen, that is by thermal decomposition of boron barium nitride by barium nitride. So how to get the barium nitride? When on heat and you will get the barium and liberation of nitrogen gas. This is barium nitride. These are the sum of the methods for the preparation of the nitrogen. One is by heating the aqueous solution of the sodium nitrite and ammonium chloride. The second method is by thermal decomposition of ammonium dichromate, and the third method is by the thermal decomposition of barium nitrite. So these are the sum of the methods for the laboratory preparation of nitrogen. Then to understand the properties of the physical properties of nitrogen, the dinitrogen, this is the dinitrogen. The dinitrogen is a colorless, odorless, tasteless, and non-toxic gas. Yes, see that under the physical property, this dinitrogen is a colorless, odorless, tasteless, and non-toxic gas. And this nitrogen exists in two isotopic form. One is nitrogen 714 and another is nitrogen 715. So these are the two isotopes of the nitrogen. As you know that isotopes means the element having same atomic number but differ in atomic mass, called as isotopes. So here there is a difference in the number of the neutrons. Then the dinitrogen is inert due to bond, high bond dissociation enthalpy. If you take the nitrogen, dinitrogen, existence of triple bond. Hence, the dinitrogen is inert in nature because the tendency of reactivity is decreased because having a more bond association enthalpy. The dinitrogen is inert due to high bond association enthalpy of the nitrogen. This is about the the physical properties of the nitrogen. Then to understand the chemical properties of nitrogen, as you know that the nitrogen dinitrogen having a high bond association enthalpy, hence it get react with high temperature.
Ahem.